Come on, Neil, earn your stripes. The self-talk kicked into action. I watched as my rivals and teammates clocked solid times. Nothing earth-shattering, but nonetheless impressive for this stage in the season. It was our turn. As expected, we made a strong start, bursting out of the gate. The first lap felt solid and aggressive, but as the race progressed, I felt I faded pretty badly. Would it be enough for the win? Had we scraped a win in the first race of the season? Matt turned to me as we crossed the line. "What's the world record?" he shouted. 59.4, why? I asked, a little confused. 59.4 what? He asked. I can't remember. At that moment we heard the announcer say, "I think that is in fact a new world record." Right, okay, so we're in pretty good shape, I thought. The world record had stood for 5 years. Pete Mitchell and I had set it at altitude in Mexico. Riding at altitude makes an enormous difference to times. The air is thinner, so the bike travels much quicker. To set this time in Manchester in January was insane. Sadly, as no anti-doping officials were present, the time couldn't be ratified. This was very frustrating given the fact I had been tested the day before during a training session. 2 days later, we followed up with a gold medal in the sprint. Less than 2 weeks later, we were racing in the national championships, again in Manchester. Could we get close to 59.422 seconds? Our race day followed much the same pattern as the last time. Nerves, Lego, velodrome, warm-up, race. As reigning world champions, we were last to race, and I had to watch my teammates go before us. They rode an incredible ride, making vast improvements from 2 weeks earlier, around 1.5 seconds quicker with a time of 59.866 seconds. Where did that come from? I asked myself. It meant they were only the third tandem ever to break the 60-second barrier at sea level. What if we don't beat that? Well, it's only the national championships. It doesn't really matter, right? Reasoned the emotional side of my brain. I've come to realise that in times of physical or mental stress, our brains like to convince us to stop what we're doing and go for the easy option. A classic case of the lizard brain kicking into action. The safe option would be to not fully commit, accept a solid second place, and move on with no repercussions. Recognising what my brain was up to, I knew I needed my mantra to snap out of it. Come on, Neil, earn your stripes. This time I shouted it out. With my lizard brain switched off, I fully committed. Another strong start.